Right. Done. 9:30. I am reloaded. Well, they were already in the process of loading a trailer, so I just had to obviously wait for it to be finished being filled. Alright. Pull over here 2 seconds. Take my boots off. Don't want to be driving all the way back with these on if I don't have to. What we're looking at. It's about 3 hours from here back. Give or take 147 miles. All depends on traffic. Seatbelt, just going onto a public highway. Clunk, click, every trip. So yes, I was in there an hour. Not too shabby. I've got a funny feeling though there will be a bit of a wait when I get to Macra, Washington, because there was two of our drivers pulling out of there when I was in there. They both have Macra, Washington on, so that means within probably about half an hour there will be 3 of us at Macra, Washington, so there will be a bit of a wait. Pretty heavy. So yeah, it'll be a bit busy when I get there. Which is little bit of an annoyance, as I'd ideally like to get there and just be able to get straight on and get it off. But never mind. I've got to sit there and wait. I'm not gonna rush back, but I'm not gonna dawdle and take me time, because one of them might have to pull over for a break. Which means if they have to pull over, I can woohoo wee straight past them. Hopefully. So yeah, hopefully that's what's gonna happen. I know one of them won't, because he had his brake at Iceland, so he'll be good to go. Mr. Thermo King thinks he needs his flashers on still. He's obviously forgot the turned on. Right, anyway, I shall crack on. And I'll see you all in a bit. Just stopped to go to the toilet. I'm going to struggle to get out of here now. Done a quick update, obviously, which you'll have all seen by now, probably. Explaining, obviously, what's going on with the videos and stuff. Any time today. Go, 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 go! Come on, truck. Build some speed up. There's another wagon coming down the hill. Come on, girl. Use your weight. Use your weight. Get going, get going. Yeah, so we're on the English side of the border now. Do apologise, Mr. Merrick. Right up the backside he is. Oh well, never mind. Yeah, so there's no chance that we'll probably catch one of the other wagons in front of us now, but like I say, I'm not going to lose any sleep over it. Oh, here's one of our boys coming in. So yeah, we're not going to catch up with one of the two wagons in front of us more than likely, but I'm not particularly fussed. Because we're still going to have to wait when we get to Washington, so I mean, it'd be nice to be in front of one of them, because then I've only got to wait for one, but if I've got to wait for two, I've got to wait for two. Current ETA is just before 1 o'clock, going to the sat-nav, and we started work at 2 o'clock, so that'll only be 11 hours working. And I've got a 15 available, so I don't really want to use it, but if I need to use a 15, I've got one. So I'm not going to start panicking. And if I've got to sit there and wait, I'll have some lunch, do some editing, probably watch a few programmes while I wait. Did not want to have to stop on a hill, but wagon behind's got tractors on, and he's a Mercedes. Let's see who's heavier, because I know Mercs don't like going uphill. If he comes past, I'm clearly heavier. I know the Beamish boys, so yeah, I'm clearly heavier. God, that's two Mercs that have gone past me today. Never mind, eh? Never mind. So, got about an hour and a half left of driving. It's not too bad. I've been told once I'm empty to check the steps on the back of this trailer work. So, either they've been reported as not working, or I don't know. I don't know why, but I will. I will check them, make sure that they're operational. It's quite possibly, because I know we were, I know a lot of the loads out of SCA in Prudder now, we're just going straight there with the fridges, getting the fridges loaded direct. So obviously you need to be able to get up in the back of it, so that's quite possibly why. But I am sure I will find out. Obviously, once I know whether they're working or not, then I'll let them know and I'll get told what I'm doing. Not going to bother stopping to refuel it, because I've got 90% diesel, 95% AdBlue. Obviously it was fueled up on the way up here, so I'm not going to bother refueling it, especially as I'm staying in it for another 2 days. There's pretty much no point. I'll be in it, so it'll only be myself that has to obviously stop and get fuel if I need it, so that'll save a bit of time. I'll be able to just carry on straight back without stopping for fuel, whereas the two wagons that are in front of me, they're going to have to stop for fuel, I believe, because both of them are day drivers, so obviously they're going to be parking the wagons up in the yard, so therefore they should be putting fuel in them so that they're parked up with fuel for whoever gets in them next. So that might give me a bit of time to get past them. It all depends how far behind them I am now. It'll only take them at most 15 minutes to fuel it, so it'll definitely put me closer to them. So yes. Shall carry on. Get it a bit further along. Right, we're just coming into the top end of Newcastle now. About 13 miles away from the delivery point at Washington, about 15 minutes worth of driving, but we're going to come skirt round the edge of Newcastle on the A1. We're going to go over the River Tyne, round past the Metro Centre, should be some stuff to look at, stuff happening. Bound to be plenty of traffic, there always is around this bit. Plenty of stuff to keep you on your toes, lots of vehicles joining and leaving. There's a lot of junctions in like close proximity of each other, so you've got to properly keep your wits about you. People will decide they suddenly want to get on and suddenly want to get off last minute without any warning, so just got to keep an eye on them all, especially all the ones like these sorts of junctions where they're coming. Keep an eye on the cars coming down the outside of me, because some of them might want the junction and they'll just nip straight across in front of you. Not seen the other wagon, so he must be further in front, unless the petrol station, like there's a fuel station that's set just off the side of the dual cut off the A1 that I know about. He might have been in there, and it's a bit hard to see if they're in there from the actual A1, so he could have been in that bit, but not to worry if he's not. Like I say, it's only one in front of us, so well, one immediately in front of us. There will have been more in front of him probably, but how many people lane hog along here. Because they normally do. They normally sit in the lane and just lane hog it, because in a minute it becomes three lanes. And they'll just sit in the middle one rather than using the left one. No doubt we'll see somebody doing it. Too slow can kill as well. Here we go, how many people aren't going to use it? Neither of the wagons are. Blue car isn't. There's a surprise. Quite shocked at the two wagons. Well, the first wagon, he's like level with the van, but the second one, he should definitely be in here. Not going any quicker than the van. This blue car most definitely should be in this lane. See it all the time along here and all the time on motorways, and it's really frustrating. Oblivious to what's going on with the lanes, they're just sitting in that middle lane. They probably just get in that middle lane when they get on a motorway and stay in it regardless of what's going on. And it really annoys me when people do it. It's like probably my biggest pet hate, other than indicators or lack of using indicators. Sitting in the middle lane is definitely pet hate of mine. Because it means we as HGVs can't get past. If you want to do 45 mile an hour, do 45 mile an hour, but get in the left lane so that those of us that want to do the speed limit can get past you. Do anything about it. Right, I shall carry on. Nearly there now, but I'll bring you back just as we get along, near enough right on top of it. Right, that's off the A1 now. Got about a mile left to go. So, nearly there. Not seeing the other wagon. So, we will find out if he's there or if he's not. And if he's not, winner. We'll be able to get in and get on the bay and get unloaded. And if he's there, like I say, it's not that big of an issue. I'll just take a chill out and have some lunch, wait for him to get unloaded. This is our exit. That fly is going to die as well. I'm going to make sure of it. Bloody hitchhiker, he's come all the way from Scotland. He'll be sweating when he gets outside down here. Outside and obviously wait for him to come out, because there's nowhere near enough room in there for the pair of us. Ooh, gotta watch these potholes, some of these are massive. Line myself up ready so when he does come out I can just reverse straight in. That'll do, pig. Put that on rest. Right, I shall see you after this is tipped.